Here we are, down off Two Rocks, Shannon Edwards. He's our first viewer segment today. You recall on last week's show I said Steve and I would like to be doing some more fishing with you viewers at home. Shannon's our first. He's brought us out here to his secret spot. Looks like it's around about 15, 20 metres of water. He's going to put us on some snapper. The wind's up, so I'm taking a small sinker off and putting a large one on. And I'm going to drift a muley out, and I'm also going to chuck a plastic around. What do you reckon, Shannon? Looks all right?
Yeah, I reckon we're in for a chance. A bit of wind around, but see how we go. Yeah, so we're just going to do a little bit of berleying, try and get him in the trail. Try and get the muley as smushy as possible, and then just sort of hand feed him out the back. Little bits and pieces, so you're not giving them too much to feed on, but enough to bring them in.
A bit of weight to it. What do we think about a...
No,
no, no,
go to the other side.
Go to the other side. Green rope. I'm on it, on the rope. Pull the blue, green rope. Panic!
Start free.
You're off. Big fish, head shakes, grabbing the bottom, round in 10, 12 metres of water. This thing's right on the bottom, like a big dewy. Couldn't be that, surely. They're a bigger net or not?
No, I know.
Well, that's not what I wanted. That's not what you wanted. Come snapper fishing. You catch a Dhufish. Well done, Shan.
Thanks, mate.
Well, we've been laying a berley trail out here for about half an hour or so now. Shannon's just hooked up on the first fish and a nice little Dhufish. Come out here to catch a snapper and catch a dewey, mate. Can't complain with that, eh?
Not too bad. We'll take something home at least. That's good. Cheers, guys.
Nice start to the day. Now we'll see if we can find these pinkies. It's nice and rough. Looks good. Muleys are a little bit frozen this morning, so a good tip. Just hold them in your hand and you'll thaw them out. Once you get them soft enough, put all that nice ice juices drift off there. Then we put our front hook through there, second hook through the back. I'll just do a little cheeky half hitch around the back of the tail as well. We'll just hold it all nice and straight. Ball sinker down onto that. Just drift that down the berley trail out the back. See what happens.
Yeah, just to start, I usually keep a bait sort of close out the back, like not too far out the back, because the berley that I'm putting in at the moment is sort of going to be hanging close to the boat anyway. And yeah, as the morning goes on, I sort of sit them further and further and further out. Find the bigger fish sort of seem to hang away from the boat. Yeah, as the session gets going, we hopefully get a few smaller ones to start and then the bigger ones will come through. It's the plan.
Whoa, bit of a head shaker. Feels like a pink snapper to me. I think Shannon's done the job.
Excellent.
Well, we've been berleying out here for about, probably half an hour, 45 minutes now. And finally, got some fish coming up in our berley trail. Shannon's just been slowly hand feeding some muleys out the back of the boat here. By the look of this rod, I'd say we've got our first pink snapper. Oh, yep, see it in the water now. Nice little pinky.
Nick, you've called two fish right in a row. This is not like you.
Yes, well, it's very shallow water, you see, Steve, so I can see them down there.
Yeah, the little ones, so I can see now it's going to start with the smaller ones, and the bigger ones usually come in straight after. So, fingers crossed. We can get a better one.
Ah, it's a starter fish. Nice work, boys.
Yeah, so I don't know, things that I look for when I'm heading out fishing. Exposed reef, sandy patches in between, like gravelly, sort of shaley stuff around the outside. You know, sort of 10 to 12 metres is a good number. You get all types of species in there, like dewies, as you can see, snapper, black ass. We get the odd tuna through here.
And you're on.
Did you say fish on?
Yeah. dust. Oh, no. Yep. No. Anyways. That sucks.
I think there's a fish snapper in the Burley Trail out there, Shan.
Yeah. Oh, that time.
Phew. Well, we've been drifting over them. Been having a bit of trouble getting them to follow us, so thought we'd sneak on up to this little sand patch that's up in front of us.
Drop the anchor in there.
Hang back here. Throw a bit of Burley back onto this nice dark hole. Bang-o! 5 minutes later, we're into one. Feels like a nice little fish.
Out.
Giving the old Loomis and Shimano combo a bit of a workout. The old Stella 5000, 20 pound Loomis graphite rod. And we got ourselves a snapper.
On you go.
Hey, beauty. Good job, Shannon, I say.
Woohoo!
Well, what a difference, eh? Drifting over them, set the anchor, the Burley back, unweighted bait down the Burley Trail. 5 minutes later, beautiful pink snapper. Thanks, Shannon.
Textbook
champion.
Cheers, Nico.
Textbook, love it.
Stuck in the bottom.
Oh, that was chewy.
It's not biting at all. I thought you were supposed to be catching a snapper, mate.
It's near the same spot as the last one.
Well, I really like Shannon's snapper spot.
You can see we're fishing with fairly light leaders.
But wow, another dewey, mate. Absolutely amazing. Well, for all you viewers out there, you'll be doing well to beat this segment. Segment one of the viewers fishing. We're cleaning up on dewey's, little pinkies. Great spot, Shannon. You're doing real well, mate.
Cheers, guys.
Let's see what else we can get, eh? Okay, I'll just show you how to quickly bait up these mealies for snapper. Snapper will generally take a bait head first. So one from one side, one in the other side. We do a half hitch around the tail of the mealie. One hook coming out of one side, one hook coming in the other one. Float around on the reef, not get snagged up. Floats down the Burley Trail, snapper swallows it head first. Bang, on. Watch this. Oh, it is his spot. It's about time he caught one.
Looking after you, boys.
He's been too busy burling them up for me. Now he's got himself one. Looks like a nice fish, yeah?
Yeah. High 70s.
Oh, he's caught the size and everything.
Oh. It better not be a Wrasse.
73 centimetre pink snapper.
No, high 70s, Nick.
High 70s, 77. I suppose you want me to net it.
You know, I see as I netted yours.
Let's get the gyro net that's designed for flathead. You got a bit in here? Whoa, what's the motor? Quite clear down there. Beautiful clear water. Just enough breeze to put a nice little ripple on it, get the snapper biting. We're on anchor now, got a nice Burley Trail going. And finally, some fish in there. Some nice fish too, mate, this one looks good. Shannon. A couple of nice pinkies, a couple of nice dewies in the boat. home before her lunch, and we haven't spent a fortune on fuel. Believe it or not, we're probably 2 kilometres offshore out here.